Okay, so next speaker is Haile from the Washington University at St. Louis.
Yeah.
And he's going to talk about precision recall.
Hi, everyone. My name is Hai from Washington University in St. Louis. This is a joy work. This is a joy work with my advisor, Professor Brandon Chuba. So the problem that we work on is class imbalance. So we all know that class imbalance is a situation when one class severely outrepresents other classes. So some practitioners claim that class imbalance make it harder for them for classifying imbalance data. But exist learning theory do not refer to class imbalance. So although there are many many methods that have been proposed to correct the imbalance, like variate sampling method or the cost-sensitive method, but we have a question like, do the method really help? So in our work, first we derive the relationship between precision recall and accuracy, and then we claim that the large data set is the only curve for class imbalance. So we prove that both theoretically and empirically. For the related work in this problem, Ridder et al. Empirically show that every metric except for accuracy depend on the class imbalance. Alvarez also discovered the relationship between precision and recall and accuracy. However, he didn't like interpret the relationship, the consequence of that relationship. So first, let's look at our derivation for the relationship between precision recall and accuracy. So our theorem is, suppose this is a distribution of an example with Boolean label and a mu, a base positive red mu, and suppose we have a classifier H with precision greater than 0.5, then our theorem is define epsilon max as the maximum of precision and recall error, then epsilon max has to satisfy mu epsilon max is less or equal than epsilon accuracy and less or equal than 3 times mu epsilon max. So in general, precision and recall is imbalance weight of accuracy scaled by the factor of 3 times the mu, the positive rate. So the consequence of this theorem is, so if we like integrate with the VC bound for accuracy, we can conclude that with probability at least 1 minus delta, at least we need 1 over mu epsilon max times d plus log 1 over delta example are necessary and sufficient to achieve precision and recall greater than 1 minus epsilon max, where d is the VC dimension of the classifier. So the present of the term 1 minus 1 over mu is very important because it leads to the consequence that when the objective is high precision and high recall, class imbalance does impose a cost on learning. That means that in order to achieve high precision and recall, it demands the size of the training data scaled by the imbalance. So we conclude that using large training data size is a curve for imbalance data because it is what controls the generalization error. So let's look at some case study when we really need high precision. Because remember when I talk about our theorem, we need the assumption that precision is greater than 0.5. So we look at some case study when we really need high precision. So the first example is the ICU alarm system for predicting cardiac arrest. So because cardiac arrest is a very rare event and it's very expensive, so we really want that when the ICU alarm system is triggered, the patient actually needs to transfer to the ICU. So indeed, we want high precision. Another example that we want to talk to is the machine translation example. So in this task, we also really need high precision and recall because you can like have high accuracy but low recall if you predict the rare word are never used. But you can also have like high accuracy but low precision. But in this case, the use of the word in the translation may be meaningless. So Brand at all has a system that shows continual improvement as the training data increase up to like 100 billion of example. So it's not too clear why he needs so much amount of data. So we did like some investigation and we see that we observed that most of the sentence contain rare word, and the frequency of the rarest word in the target sentence will determine the amount of data that required to reliably translate the sentence. So we did an experiment on the New York Times corpus, and we observed that like at least 1.5 million examples are necessary to like correctly learn like 55% of the sentence. So for the experiment part, the aim of this the experiment part is to verify our conclusion that using large training data size is necessary to cope with class imbalance. So in order to do that, we're gonna compare the performance of different techniques for fixing class imbalance versus a no modification version, but train on a larger training size. So the data set that we use in this experiment is a drug discovery data set with about 1 million negative label and of just like 62,000 positive label. So in the first part of the experiment, first we stratify the data into like 24 and with about 50,000 sample each. And then we select one flow and like we create different model by resampling it using different like imbalance techniques like oversampling, undersampling, smooth. And then we change the model using KNN. For the rest of the data, we change using KNN, and we repeat the experiment 200 times and compare the performance. So you can see when you for the no modification version, when change on a large data size, we'll have significant higher precision and recall than the model that use different imbalance techniques. In the second part of the experiment, we compare the performance by different data set size from 1,100 to 50 to 500,000 sample, and you can see that the precision and recall scale when the size of the data set increased in the no modification version. So to conclude, we conclude that it is not possible to achieve high precision and recall under severe class imbalance unless you have like a certain amount of data. And we claim that the method for correcting class imbalance don't help, and you shouldn't choose a classifier on a typical typical size data set with high imbalance, because it is very similar to the situation that you have low accuracy on a small data set size. So our advice is when you have to deal with class imbalance but you don't have enough data, our advice is to, rather than trying different techniques for correcting the imbalance, you try to explore some prior knowledge about the domain. Like for example, for the machine translation example that I talked before, you can like try to look for the definition of the word in the dictionary rather than like trying different technique for correcting balance. That's all my talk. Thank you, everyone.